Hello everyone and welcome to MediSimplified. So today in this video, we are going to discuss the dermatopathological terms, which are the very basics of dermatology, which one should know to know the disease in depth. So let's begin this video. And at the end of this video, I will be discussing the two important lines in dermatology, which is not a part of a dermatopathological term, but yes, it is very important to know. So let's begin. So we are going to talk about the dermatopathological terms. So first thing which we have here is this first question thing is thickening of stratum corneum. If there is a thickening of stratum corneum, it is given a name that is hyperkeratosis. That is hyperkeratosis. Okay, now next thing is retention of nucleus in stratum corneum. If you remember when we were talking about the, when we discussed the layers of epidermis, I told you that stratum basale has tall elongated cells, columnar cells with centrally located nucleus. Whereas when we discuss about stratum corneum, I told you that it is a flat cell with no nucleus, right? But if there is a retention of nucleus, if there is a retention of nucleus here, you can see in the stratum corneum, the nucleus is present, which normally should not be there. So if there is a presence of nucleus, this is termed as parakeratosis. This is termed as parakeratosis. I hope I'm clear till here now. So thickening of stratum corneum, which is the topmost layer of epidermis, is called as hyperkeratosis, whereas retention of nucleus in the stratum corneum, which is not a normal thing to have, is called as parakeratosis. Now we'll talk about thickening of stratum granulosum. Once again, thickening of stratum granulosum is called as hypergranulosis. It is called as hypergranulosis. And very important thing to know that hypergranulosis is seen in a disease which is very commonly seen in, not commonly seen in clinics, but very commonly studied, that is lichen planus. It is lichen planus. Now going further, I will similarly, as the thickening of stratum granulosum is called as hypergranulosis, we don't have a term for the next thing, that is absent or decreased stratum granulosum, but it is seen in few diseases, that is psoriasis and ichthyosis vulgaris. So it is very important to know thickening of stratum granulosum seen in lichen planus, whereas absent or decrease in the size of stratum granulosum is seen in psoriasis and ichthyosis vulgaris. Ichthyosis basically means fish-like scales. If you see the fish, it has a scales like this somewhat. I'm not exactly showing you, but somewhat like this, there are scales are present in fish. So ichthyosis vulgaris means fish-like scaling, ichthyosis, and vulgaris means most common. In dermatology, wherever you see vulgaris term, it means most common. So it is seen, a decrease or absent stratum granulosum is seen in psoriasis and ichthyosis vulgaris. Now going further, there is accumulation of water in the stratum spinosum. If there is accumulation of water in stratum spinosum, this accumulation can be intracellular or it can be intercellular. If it is intercellular, it is called as spongiosis. And it is seen in a very common disease called as acute eczema. If I'm not wrong, it is seen in acute eczema. Okay, so spongiosis is seen in acute eczema, whereas if we talk about the intracellular accumulation of water in the stratum spinosum, it has a given a different name, that is ballooning degeneration. I might be wrong in the spelling, but do remember the term ballooning degeneration. It is intracellular water accumulation in the stratum spinosum, and this is seen in a infection, that is herpes simplex virus infection. So water accumulation in the stratum spinosum is called as balloonin degeneration if it is intracellular, and it's called as spongiosis if it is intercellular. Now going further, after this, a very important thing, that is thickening of, so thickening of stratum spinosum. It is called as acanthosis. Spine is also abbreviated as acantha. So thickening of stratum spinosum is called as acanthosis. Whereas loss of the spinous process at stratum spinosum is called as acantholysis. Now this acantholysis is a very important term for further studies, right? For further subject of derma. So we will have a bit in-depth discussion about acantholysis. So if we talk about acantholysis, what exactly happens in acantholysis, that the desmosomes are targeted. Desmosome is a protein which connects the keratinocytes, right? So if the desmosomes are targeted, what will happen? We will see loss of attachment between the keratinocytes. The keratinocytes which is attached through the desmosome is been, the attachment is lost. Then what happens? Due to this, a round cell with prominent nucleus and a perinuclear halo is seen, and this is known as acantholytic cell. And where do we see this cell? This cell is seen in a special smear known as Zank smear. And that is why this acantholytic cell is also called as Zank cells. Alright, acantholysis, what happens? The desmosomes are targeted, and due to this targeted desmosome, the keratinocytes lose their attachments. And when they lose their attachment, a round cell with a prominent nucleus and a perinuclear halo is seen. This is seen on a smear called as Zank smear, and these cells are known as acantholytic cell or Zank cell, as it is seen on a Zank smear. Now going further, and let's see, where do we see this acantholysis, in which diseases, right? So if we go further, so before talking about the diseases, it is very important to know it once again diagrammatically. So suppose this is the keratinocyte, right? This is the keratinocyte, and this greenish is the desmosome. If there is a loss of desmosome, what we see? We see a rounded cell with a central nucleus, and around this nucleus we see a halo that is called as perinuclear halo, right? So somewhat this kind of cell is seen, and this is known as Zank cell or acantholytic cell. Acantholytic cells, right? Now this acantholysis can be seen in many different diseases. So first is what happens, the autoantibody is formed. Against what the autoantibody is formed? It is formed against desmosome, and the disease is known as pemphigus group of disease. Okay, now this thing can be seen also in infection and also due to some genetic disease, right? So if it is seen due to bacterial infection, it can be two things. It can be bullous impetigo. This thing I mean with acantholysis. So it can be bullous impetigo, or it can be SSSS, that is staphylococcal scalded skin syndrome. And if it is a viral disease, it can be due to herpes simplex virus. Acantholysis can often occur due to herpes simplex virus. Where else we learn about the herpes simplex virus involvement? It was seen in balloonin degeneration, if I'm not wrong. What was balloonin degeneration? It was intracellular accumulation of water in stratum spinosum. All right. Also, this acantholysis can be seen due to genetic defects. And what are the disease where we see the genetic defect due to which acantholysis occur? One is Hailey-Hailey disease, and another one is Darius disease. Right. So these are the three important things which you should know where we see this disease, right? Autoantibodies form against desmosome. Acantholysis occurs in pemphigus group of disease. If the desmosomes are targeted due to infection, if it is a bacterial infection, it can be in bullous impetigo or SSSS, or if it is a viral infection, it can be due to HSV. Genetic defect of desmosomes can also occur. It occurs in two diseases. One is Hailey-Hailey disease and another one is Darius disease. So this was very important to know. Now let's go further. And we will talk about premature keratinocytes. All right. What we'll talk about? Premature or abnormal keratinocyte. If there is a premature or abnormal keratinocyte, it is called as dyskeratosis. Dyskeratosis. And now this dyskeratosis is seen in very important three diseases. One is the squamous cell carcinoma. Another one is Bowen's disease. And the very important, which we just discussed, is the Darius disease, where we saw acantholysis. So acantholysis as well as dyskeratosis can be seen in Darius disease. All right. Now let's move further. And we will talk about a very special thing, same as acantholysis, is the microabscess. We know about abscess. Abscesses means accumulation of pus, right? Large accumulation of pus. Now microabscess means collection, along with the pus, there is a collection of a cell. So it is called as microabscess. Now this microabscess, the collection can be of atypical cells or it can be a collection of neutrophils. So first we'll talk about this atypical cells. The collection of atypical cells at stratum spinosum is known as Potrier's microabscess. I will denote microabscess by MA, right? It is called as Potrier's microabscess and it is seen in a very famous disease called as mycosis fungoides. Thing which we should remember about mycosis fungoides, it is a most common cutaneous. It is most common cutaneous B cell lymphoma. So Potrier's microabscess is seen as mycosis fungoides, which is a most common cutaneous T cell lymphoma. Now talking about the collection of neutrophils, if the neutrophils is collected at stratum corneum, it is called as Munro's microabscess. Whereas if it is collected in the neutrophil is collected in stratum spinosum, it is called as spongiform pustules of Kogos or Kogos, whatever you want to say. And these two things is seen in a very common disease once again called as psoriasis. Right, so Munro's microabscess and spongiform pustule of Kogos is seen in psoriasis. That is a collection of neutrophil. If the collection is at the stratum corneum, it is called as Munro's microabscess. If it is in the stratum spinosum, it is called as spongiform pustule of Kogos. Now going further, so if there is the collection of neutrophils below epidermis or at the tip of papilla of dermis, it is called as papillary tip microabscess. All right. So this papillary tip microabscess, why this is the name? Because it is seen at the tip of papilla of dermis. So papillary tip microabscess, and it is seen in a very common disease called as dermatitis herpetiformis. Now, at the end, we should discuss the two important lines in dermatology, which I told you is not a part of this discussion, but we should know it. Right. So, lines in dermatology. First, we'll talk about Langer's line. Langer's line is the line of skin tension, and it helps us to give incision. Right? So very important thing to know. Now, second and important is the Blaschko's line. It is the line of embryological development. Embryological development. And it is V-shaped at the upper spine, and it is S-shaped at abdomen. So V-shaped at upper spine and S-shaped at abdomen. And this line of embryological development is not a pathology, it is a normal line, right? So that was about lines in dermatology. If you want a quick review, we can go further and have a fast review. Dermatopathological term, thickening of stratum corneum is called as hyperkeratosis. Retention of nucleus in stratum corneum is called as parakeratosis. Thickening of stratum granulosum is called as hypergranulosis, and it is seen in lichen planus. Absent or decrease of stratum granulosum is seen in psoriasis and ichthyosis vulgaris. Accumulation of water in stratum spinosum can be intracellular. It is called as balloon degeneration. If it is intercellular, it is called as spongiosis. Thickening of stratum spinosum is called as acanthosis, whereas loss of spinous process at stratum spinosum is called as acantholysis. Acantholysis, what happens? Desmosomes are targeted and loss of attachment between keratinocytes is seen. And due to acantholysis, on Zank smear, we see acantholytic cell or a Zank cell. Acantholysis can be seen in the following disease. If autoantibodies form against desmosome, it is seen in pemphigus group of disease. If it is due to the infection, like bacterial infection, we see in bullous impetigo and SSSS. And if it is a viral disease, it is seen in herpes simplex virus. If we talk about genetic defect, the acantholysis can be seen due to genetic defect in Hailey-Hailey disease and Geyer's disease. Dyskeratosis is premature or abnormal keratinocyte, which is seen in squamous cell carcinoma, Geyer's disease or Bowen's disease. Collection of cells along with pus is called as microabsis. If it is the atypical cells collection and the stratum spinosum, it is called as Potrius microabsis, seen in mycosis fungoides. If it is collection of neutrophils at the stratum corneum, it is called as membranous microabsis. If it is the collection of neutrophil at stratum spinosum, it is called as spongiform pustule of Kogos. And this both thing, membranous microabsis and spongiform pustule of Kogos, is seen in psoriasis. Collection of neutrophil below epidermis or at the tip of papilla of dermis is called as papillary tip microabsis, and it is seen in dermatiformis, dermatitis herpetiformis. Lines of Langer and lines of Blaschko. Lines of Blaschko is line of embryological development, whereas lines of Langer is a line of skin tension. So yeah, this was all I had to discuss in this video. Thanks for watching this video. Hope you find this video very useful. Do like, share and subscribe my channel Mendel Simplified, and do not forget to share this video with your friends. Thank you.